5'9" offensive threat, Hall of Fame shooting, Hall of Fame finishing, in the stage, using screens, no ISO option other than a 6'10" blue red, sitting on the block if need be. This is playing exactly like a play shot would play in the stage. No asterisks, nothing. All right, straight play shot type gameplay, showing you what the build is capable of at a 91 overall. GVO family, can we hit 500 likes on this video? If you've been enjoying the videos, the quality of the video, then smack that like button. Subscribe if you're still not subscribed to the channel. Welcome to the GVO family, because I know you, hey, you a real one, all right? You a real one. That's why you're going to hit that subscribe button. That's why you're going to like this video. Anyways, you see my boy Kai, you got that drippy face scan. If you want that drippy face scan, let that man know that you want the drippy face scan from Caillou. He's on a new two-way tempo pusher. Matter of fact, he kind of looked like a two-way tempo pusher. I got my real face scan in the game for those that keep asking for their face creation. It's my real face scan, bro. I can't let you. I don't know how to create it for you, bro. Now, this is very, very interesting. At first, I did not know Robo was on a blue red. I thought he was on his glass cleaning facilitator that can shoot threes from up top and set screens and finish in the paint, get contact dunks, all that stuff. That's the build we usually run with. But I didn't realize he said he was gonna bring out his blue red, putting me in a situation where I have to use screens. There is no ISO option unless they're doubling sit block. That's just like how play shots play in the stage. Real play shots. This is a catfish play shot, offensive threat. Now don't get it twisted. Out of all the games we play, we only lost two games, and it was against a really glitchy guard. They had a good game plan. But for the most part, using this build in a strictly screens lineup, no bailouts, no nothing, just straight screens like we're playing with a real play shot, I'm not gonna lie, man, I'm surprised at what he was able to do at a 91 overall, taking in consideration it's only gold playmaking, it's a 97 speed, 95 acceleration. Since I messed up on the Gatorade workout, it sucks that we have to grind every single season to get gym rat on every single build when we hit level 40 one time, right? We gotta hit level 40 every single time to get gym rat on a new build if you didn't make it within that same season. That's something that 2K needs to address. They need to fix it. They also need to fix the my court issue, because I'm not gonna lie, that executive suite, they could have done a little bit better. But I mean, I'd rather that than the one we got, man. I'm trying to get in there, and if I'm practicing my drip moves, let me look at least, you know, in a decent type settings, right? Muandena, you know, give me some good vibes in the my court, man. Now, we were playing against an ISO lineup. And, you know, I love to ISO, man. Y'all know every single year I pretty much ISO. This is an ISO type build. I just made it in a way that can fit the playstyle of screens as well, so that it's not one dimensional. It's not only an ISO build, because I have builds that are only ISO builds and builds that are only screens build. I mean, you can ISO with a play shot even if it doesn't have a dunk, don't get me wrong, but having a dunk does help a lot on ISO, especially against a goated lockdown. You're gonna need that dunk, bro. All right. Because sometimes, you, like I said, when you're ISOing, you don't have this option right here for the big man to take that slip. You can get backdoor cuts and all that stuff, but it doesn't always work out. When you're ISOing, you're going to need to be able to go get that too if you need to. And it's not always going to come down to you relying on your skill hitting a mid-range or something. Now, you're going to need to go out there and boom out. But you see this build right here? It has unlocked a new level of fun for your brethren, right? I have been having too much fun with this build on NBA 2K22. It has unlocked new levels of fun for me. I'm able to do everything I can do. Like on 2K20, the only thing this build doesn't get is like contact dunks on 2K20, right? If I wanted contact dunks, I would have to choose slash and takeover, but I wanted it to be like a real play shot. But when I ISO, I get park dunks at 99 with Hall of Fame finishing. And I'm not gonna lie,
that's gonna I gotta show you the pausing clip. I got it wrecked, and it was with a contact. I gotta show you, bro.
It can get real boring playing on one build the whole entire year. That's why when people say, you know, they're tired of this game, I'm like, have you tried anything else new? Trust me, trying new things keeps the game refreshing, whether it's new jump shots, new dribble moves, whether it's new builds. But if you just stay on one thing the whole entire year, you can't really blame the game for being dry, because you're the one being dry. You're not open to try new things when it comes to the video game, right? You're not open to see if, you know, maybe another play style, maybe this works, maybe that works. You're just married to the fact that this is you, this is what you're gonna do, and there's nothing else about it, bro. And in most situations in life, that's a good mentality to have when it comes to discipline and stuff like that. But when you're talking about NBA 2K you want to venture off. If you only want to play guard, you want to see what other guard builds are out there that you can use. Like for me, I always wait till I have at least 4 or 5 guard builds in the belt before I go out and make the meta guard build. I've been like that since pretty much 2K20, right? I always want to try other builds first and see if there's anything that's worth, you know, using them for, right? Sometimes it's, I'm out of luck, right? Sometimes I get a gem. Like this build right here is a gem. But not everybody can use this build, right? This build does take a little bit of skill to use the way you see me using. Not many people dare use an offensive threat using screens with inside big and stage, especially at a 91 overall with gold playmaking. Playshot, it doesn't matter. That Hall of Fame playmaking, and you have a high 3-ball off rip, you have no fear, man. You know what you have to do on a play shot, and you're gonna get it done. But you see me, even on this possession right here, I was open a lot of times, but that's just a part of me getting used to the new gameplay, the new game style, right? I'm using screens and I never really do that. If I have to go into war, I'm an ISO, but I want to be able to change that narrative and go out there and essentially go to war using screens too, right? That's something that I want to do. Keeping the game fun and entertaining for me, trying new things. I know I can ISO up there with the best of them, right? Because once you know how to dribble and you know how to shoot.
You know what, you're trying too hard, buddy. You're trying too hard, bruh.
Nope.
And you have IQ, you can pretty much compete with anybody on ISO if you got good defenders and good teammates, right? But you'll see a lot of people that know how to ISO elite on this game. They don't use screens, not because they hate screens, but because they don't want to admit that, you know, it's something new, it's something different. They don't want to get doubled, and it can be easy for those that have IQ, but at the same time, it's just like screens players that don't want to admit that ISO can be very difficult as well and very pressuring. It's not easy as using screens. ISO is harder than using screens, in my opinion. So it's vice versa. I just say, you know what, I'm going out there and doing things differently.
It's all good. On them last two shots.
I mean, if you just look at my whole YouTube, like me and my boy Caillou was talking about all the day, I really didn't have nobody to help me get up here where I'm at, man. I had to get it on my own and figure stuff out on my own, but I give out stuff for free with nothing in return, right? I give out free game. I try to help as much people as I can on this YouTube stuff because I know what it's like, right? So me coming up by myself kind of figured out, like, man, you know what, when I was in that situation, I wish there was somebody else out there that can help me figure out what I need to do to get where I need to be. What I'm trying to show you is that you can be yourself, be different, do whatever you want. You don't have to follow all the trends for this YouTube stuff.
And you still jumping. Send it.
Now you see that I'm performing really, really good. Now this was against the ISO lineup. This next gameplay, you'll see me against another play shot in a comp meta type setting, right? Meta play style, inside big, lockdown, and a play shot. I'm on an offensive threat. Just remember that. Offensive threat. And you're going to really notice, like, every time I show you this build, it doesn't really look like much of a difference than play shots, even though the play shots have Hall of Fame playmaking. Now, this build has Hall of Fame shooting, so it's pretty much the same thing. But it doesn't have the 3-pointer of a play shot off rip. It has the 3-pointer of a play shot at 99 starting off. Play shots start off with like an 89 3-ball, 91 3-ball, some builds. Some play shot builds start off with a 91 3-ball plus the arm sleeve. 92. Send it. Right, so hey, when you make this build, just know that this build is for people that really want to be a little bit different, right? Not even a little bit, a lot different, because you don't see this often. And for people that want to try new things, right? You want to try ISO with this build, give it a shot. There's a 5'10" version I dropped that gets 75 dunks by just going up an inch in height. This version gets park dunks, but it's really a glitched version of the build because you're not supposed to get park dunks with that height, right? Because that height to me makes it feels even more faster. It feels like a real play shot, and that's what I love about this build. It feels identical to my 5'8 play shot. In some ways, sometimes I prefer this build because it dribbles a little bit faster. I don't know why. Even with silver quick chain, I do not know why. And it also shoots a little bit smoother. I can't tell you why, but I'm telling you the truth. If you had both builds in your hands and you clutch rebound, but you're going to see that it was literally just a bunch of turnovers that kept them close. I did have a couple turnovers that could have been avoided, but nonetheless, you see that this is a 5'9" threat competing with a basically a 5'8", 5'9", probably 5'10" play shot on the other side. And is really out here competing to the very end. I love this build. I'm really trying hard to get it to a 99 fast. I want to get this build to a 99 because this is my main guard build now. I keep telling y'all because I love to ISO and now I like to use screens as well. So I have the ability to do both on this at an elite level because this build gets park dunks. And there are certain park dunks that you can trigger every time that are literally unstoppable if you know what you're doing. But I already have the three dunks and quick drops off one with this build. So that's pretty much the only dunks you really need if you want to talk about getting the two every time, not worrying about getting blocked. But once you get those park dunks, you can go to the rim and do something flashy, and they're gonna be like, that's not no play shot. They go check your player card and be like, man, it's a play shot, but it's not a play shot. That's what the build is for, man. Big up on yourself. I'm big up with what I'm mighty. What else we can do? Not dodge. Even though I don't know the thing already, y'all, man, gaming gone.